everybody. Nice to see you here. I'm also on the board of SACUS, and I want to thank you all for being here to help SACUS raise awareness about gender violence and about the services SACUS offers to victims and survivors, and being here to make a public statement about our refusal to condone violence in our community, and to make a statement about showing your support for people who have been victimized by gendered violence. Take Back the Night events began with two primary purposes: to inform people about how often gendered violence occurs, and to protest the ways individuals and institutions respond to gendered violence. When Take Back the Night first started in the 1970s, and there's a lot of controversy about when that was, it was focused exclusively on critiquing the pornography industry and raising awareness about rape and murder of women in public spaces. One of the first Take Back the Night marches that I know of was held in San Francisco in 1973. 5 years later, in 1978, San Francisco's Take Back the Night march included 3,000 women marchers, several artists and performers, and a huge float, you know, like you do at homecoming, right? A huge float filled with pornography that the marchers ripped apart as they marched through the streets of San Francisco. Between 1973 and 1978, there were Take Back the Night events, huge ones, in Philadelphia, New York, Pittsburgh, Los Angeles, and many other U.S. cities, as well as in Belgium, Italy, West Germany, England, and Canada. In 1979, U.S. feminist author Andrea Dworkin explained the philosophy behind Take Back the Night in the 70s. This is what she wrote. It's a little long. Bear with me.
I feel very comfortable speaking on behalf of the individuals that we work with because I've gotten to know them.